Now, there's actually another property of sound that we haven't talked about, and that property is called timbre. So let me give you an example of this. I'm going to play a couple sounds for you. So first, listen to this. And now, listen to this. Could you tell the difference?
Well, yeah. One was a guitar and one was a piano.
Now, that's interesting that you could distinguish, because they both had the exact same pitch and they had the same volume. So this difference between the sounds is what's called timbre.
So this is basically the difference in the quality of the sound.
Yeah, you could think of it like that, which sort of leads to the next question.
Is that what property of the sound wave makes us perceive timbre?
Right, and it's the wave's complexity. That's the property of the sound wave that lets us perceive timbre. And what I mean by that is like this. This is what we would call a pure wave. But some waves are complex, like this one. And it's this complexity that allows us to perceive a wave's timbre.
Okay, I think this makes sense, but it's a lot of information. Let me make sure I understand.